Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Elden Ring. Picking up right where we left off, there was a boss down in this hole who I lied about. I said I was going to come back and beat him before ending the last episode, but that didn't happen because, well, he gave me the business. As most of the bosses, I'm sure from this point on, will. So, with that being said, we are gonna come back to this guy soon. But I did also remember that yesterday we found this other shield. Ooh. Which is much heavier than the one we already have. So I don't really see much of a point of using it at the moment. But nevertheless, we still have a pretty solid option for our shield. And riding the horse and killing things is still very nice. Spirit spring jumping. Pressing X. Okay, so these giant wind things, the horse can jump up. Whoa, wow. It really jump up. Alright, we didn't really want to come up here though, so it's a bit of an issue. So see how big of a fall the horse can survive. Oh, pretty nice. Nice, nice. Easy peasy. Alright. Let's make our way. So we saw this interesting fort, I want to call it. A bridge fort of sorts. Last time we were here. I got distracted, though. See? That's how it always goes. You see something else somewhere, and you gotta go take a look at it. So, we're gonna see if there's anything hiding over here. And it doesn't look like it. Just some crafting materials, which, you know, are helpful, of course. But not something we're looking for at the moment. So, we'll make our way to this mysterious bridge. And look at that delayed double jump. That's beautiful. Kind of a strange thing to have in a game like this. But I feel like it's fitting. It's kind of weird the enemies don't even notice me as I'm standing here. But oh, now they see me after I swing my sword. Alright. Back to it. Wow. Okay. They have some sort of catapult over there. Bad choice. The Bridge of Sacrifice. Okay. I'm willing to go across the Bridge of Sacrifice. Wow! Okay, didn't see that coming. My gosh. Okay. New approach. Rush. Get the long sword out. Ooh! Okay, that killed that guy, which is good. Alright, main order of business is the guy on the ballista. How can we kill him? Oh my gosh, we gotta platform our way. Oh, no, no. Rough start today, guys. Rough start today. My gosh. Alright, I'm sorry about that. That was not a good beginning. Not a good beginning at all. And we're back. Quick pause there to adjust a few things. Just to make sure we're looking good. You know, I think at this moment, I'm gonna abuse the horse. And I don't mean abuse it as in the horse itself, but I mean abuse the horse mechanic. Because I can. Oh, wow. That guy just dismounted me. And now we've got a gang of dudes that are angry. I'm sure there's some more over there. Okay. Let's pace ourselves here. This might be more of a great sword moment. Oh! Alright. Wow. A little tougher than the other guys have been. Let's just keep it cool. Keep it cool. Alright. I'm gonna rock one of these. Back it up. Oh. Wow. As you can see, even after not playing for the day, you lose some of your skills. Oh, okay. Godric Greaves, acquire. Man, they really made the items take up a lot of space on the screen in this game. You pick them up, and I gotta say, it's a little annoying. Alright. Let's two-hand on this guy. Let's try to get a good dodge. Nice falling. There we go. Okay. Not bad. Not my best work. We did kill them all. Not really first try since we... Oh, one more. One more guy. Let's just give him the old... easy kill. Right in the back. Okay. Wow, they're dropping weapons for me. Okay, I'm all for this. Foot soldier gauntlets. A smithing stone. I did need another one of those. Except the problem is at the moment I'm not quite sure which of my weapons I'd really want to upgrade. Because I'm not really in love with this greatsword so far. Mainly because it doesn't have a thrust attack. It does have the nice two-handed 360 swing, I'm not gonna lie. Ooh, and a swordstone key. Alright, good finds all around on this bridge. I'm gonna check out some of that armor we picked up to give that a look. And we got another sight of grace over there. So, let's hit a quick pause. I would like to check out this war pick. The war pick. Its weapon art is kick. A war kick. Alright, let's just take a look at it. I just want to see it. Show it off. Oh, wow, it's tiny. Tiny, tiny. I thought it was going to be much bigger than that. It's pretty fast. Got a nice slam. Okay. I'm a fan of the war pick, but I'm not going to use it. Not going to be using that. Going to stick with our Lord's Worn straight sword for now. Did find some other armor. We got a selection of Godric Soldier. Let's see. Does this, I don't mind. Oh, we can get more poise from these. So I'm actually going to throw one of those on. Let's see how it looks. Or no. Oh. Where is the, whatever. Okay, those don't look bad. We didn't find any good armor. Got some different legs. A little heavier, but a little more defense. Let's just keep what we have for now. Still can't put our helmet back on, which is still annoying. But whatever. Alright, nighttime is approaching, it seems. And we have arrived at the Weeping Peninsula. Pretty good name, I would say. I'm gonna touch the site of grace. And we might as well hit a rest. Let's see, do we have enough to... Oh, not even close to a level up right now. Alright, nothing really can do. So, maybe we'll take a look at the map? Alright, we cannot see anything over here. This is a mystery zone for us. So, I guess we'll just check it out. It's really all we can do. So we're gonna run on over and see what's down here. Oh my gosh. This doesn't seem like a hostile enemy.
Hello? Is somebody there? Might I bend your ear for a moment, please? My name is Irina. I've escaped from Castle Morn to the south. The servants there have rebelled. I can't be sure what it is. My eyesight's been weak since birth, you see. But I swear I heard frightful howling from all over. My good father secreted me out the castle, but decided himself to stay. He says it's his duty. As commander.
Okay.
I fear for father's life. The servants are full of wrath, filled with hatred for every one of us. They've since come for every one of the companions I escaped with. They haven't spared a soul. I fear it's no different at Castle Morn. Please, I implore you, would you mind taking a letter to my father? At the castle, my soul wishes that he escape, even if his honor should be the price. Please. I just want him to be safe.
Of course.
Thank you, dearly. Then please, take this.
All right, Irina's letter.
Deliver it to my father, who remains in the castle, if you please.
All right, so she wants us to deliver a letter to her father, who's in Castle Morn, as she called it. I'm assuming that's going to be... Oh, I keep forgetting this mechanic. You hold up the torch. Hold it up. All right. I'm assuming the castle's somewhere over here. I know we're straying from the... Hey! Get down. Sorry, the cat jumped up right next to my computer. Okay. So there's a lot of dead people over here. There's a giant. There's also one of the carts that we've been able to rob. Well, we've found a few cool things so far. So let's see if we can't sneak our way in here and steal ourselves something else. All right. No one's noticed us yet. Another dog, though. Never good. Okay. We got some different enemies over there than we've seen so far. These guys are pretty familiar. I hope people have noticed, when you backstab a sitting enemy, they'll slowly stand up for you, which I find rather funny. All right, what do we got? A Morning Star. Solid weapon. Possibly a solid weapon. I've never used too many maces or hammers in these games. Much more of a sword guy. It's always just been how it is. All right, so what it looks like to me is if we want any hopes of defeating that big guy, we're gonna need to kill these things. First things first. Okay, that's two of them down. Oh my gosh. Alright, well, that wasn't as effective as I wanted to be, but we're ready to try and take on this. Okay, one more dog. Everyone knows that dogs are the most annoying enemy in any From Software game, and they manage to show up in every From Software game. They're always much faster than you. They glitch out the camera. They don't do a lot of damage, but it seems like when they do manage to hit you, they do about 5 hits at once. Now, are we thinking that we can hit a sneak attack on this guy? Because I'm not. So, the fact that we can get down here, I think we're just going to have to do what we know works. We're just going to give him this. And that. Okay. I messed this up last time. There we go. Well, this is going to turn out to be an easy kill. We can just ride off. That we just knocked him down to half health already. Alright. Now, we are familiar with this guy a little bit. because we fought one. That was actually the first enemy we killed. Alright, so there he goes. Wow. Okay, that is a thunderous slam he has there. Let's see. Okay. Probably one more attack in there. Oh wow, that's a lot like the ape from Sekiro. The ape was a very difficult boss. But this guy's, Alright, we definitely have a better hang than we did on the first time. Oh, thank you. He killed the other guy for me. Alright, let's finish the job. Whoa! Good dodge. More like a lucky dodge than a good dodge. Alright. Game over for giant number two. Didn't drop anything, but I think he restored our flask a little bit. So we'll take that. We definitely could have snuck past that guy and not had to deal with all that. But I'm in the business of checking things out. It looks like maybe these guys are gonna let us get a sneak on them. And these are some creatures, I'll tell you that. Part man, part lizard? They have a weird tail. I mean, probably part dragon. Not the toughest enemies. Okay, that's good. Four hits of the longsword. Okay, let's see if we can pump them a little harder with the greatsword. More smithing stones, alright. We'll just give this guy the backstab. Not really worth trying to do anything fancier than that. What do we have here? Little materials. So these guys were eating these guys, it looks like. The four sword soldiers, or foot soldiers. Weird how they were all hanging out right by each other. Alright, so this is one of those guys that restores one of our flasks. Oh. Forget about that thing. I see an opportunity. For a jump. Not much over here, it looks like. Just some ruin fragments. Okay. Oh, all right. Let's keep moving. See what else we can find over here. I'm guessing that might be the castle that the maiden back there told us about. Be wonderful if we could find a map fragment around here. And, you know, that fire is drawing my attention. So, oh wait, well. This is like a destroyed castle wall. Do we have an enemy over here? Oh no! It's another friend. Okay. Let's dismount. Let's rock out on this side of grace. Have ourselves a quick rest. Pop back up. And let's check in with our friend over here. This is a new guy, not the same dude. Buying or selling is all he asked. He's just a nomadic merchant. Alright, I like it. He doesn't need to tell us too much. Let's see what he has to sell. Nothing we need. He's got the bastard sword. A crossbow. But, like I said, I'm looking for a bow, but not a crossbow. Shield. He's got a medallion, which could help us out a little bit. But nothing too crazy. I think we're just gonna pass. Maybe there's some stuff that would be worth it for us to sell in order to level up a bit more. The Stomp Ash of War was not great. All the weapons we have are not worth much. Yeah, looks like we don't have anything to do with each other, my friend. And, oh, it's such a mystery right now because we have no map. But, as we know in this game, exploring something usually yields some sort of reward. So that can throw us up, I'm guessing, right up to the castle. This also looks like something... Don't a lot of these look like you should be climbing them? But that's way too tall of a jump. So definitely not. Alright. So this is probably just going to overlook where we just were, I would assume. Oh no. What is this? Well, I guess we're finding out. Okay. Creepy enemies. They have magic. Some sort of dark magic, it would seem. Alright. Alright. As we all know, I love the horse. But I try not to just be addicted to it because it is so gosh darn strong. The speed you have on there. And it seems like your weapon swings do more damage on it. Okay, I don't know what that flash thing is. Okay, they have a larger creature soldier. Wow. Good lucky dodge there. Oh my gosh. Ganked is what I call that. Is there a sight of grace here? Oh my gosh. Okay, hold on. Wow. Wow. Alright, we gotta run a little further. Gotta run a little further. Oh my gosh. Okay. I'm ready to take this guy on. Alright, luckily we can stagger this guy, not... Whoa. Interesting move. Alright, no magic. Oh, wow. Great sword's failing me. Wow! Okay, this guy's got some unique stuff going on. Alright, let's finish it. Alright. Gosh. Alright. Ah. Okay. That guy certainly was tough. And he didn't give us anything. I always feel like the tough guys, I deserve a reward. But he looked like he was the main attraction for these fools over here. So we'll just clean up. Wow. He turned his weapon into a giant thing. Okay. And yes, it looks like there's a lot of sights of grace in this game. A lot more than you find with... Oh. Is it not? Oh, it is. A lot more than you would have found in the old games compared to the bonfires. I'm currently not going to rest at it. Because, okay, so that's going to lead back up to that castle that we already had eyes on. So that's good. But the question really is, where else can we go? We are explorers. And this ruin has nothing on top of it. That's Stormveil over there. This is that's the hole in the wall. We ran over this way. Okay. Looks like I'm gonna check out what's around over here to the left. and I'll acquire those. All right. The journey continues. You know, we could probably rest there just to be safe, but I'll play on the edge a bit. I'll play on the edge. All right. Gosh, I gotta say, it's so different playing a From Software game that is so open like this. I just feel like I'm missing things. Wow, oh my gosh, that can't be how that's supposed to be. Hope everyone saw how much that was just fluttering around. A great dragonfly head. Okay. We could always use one of those, I would guess. Crafting item. Oh, shoot. There is a door over there. Oh, okay, so this is just the backside of the bridge. We have a door over here. I'm stuck. Okay. There we go. Let's give this a look-see. Perhaps it's another way into the castle? Or it's a catacomb of sorts. Impaler's Catacombs. That's such a terrible name, the Impaler's Catacombs. You know, I've often thought catacombs is a good word to use instead of an asshole. Your catacomb, got a dirty catacomb. It's fitting, right? A catacomb's at the bottom of something. But this is the Impaler's Catacomb, and impaling someone is... Well, Vlad the Impaler would stick things up people's asses, large spikes. So, it's a fitting name, the Impaler's Catacomb. We're gonna get a little level up while we're here, just because we have the runes for it. Gonna pump a little more strength. And that'll be awesome. All right, let's dive in to the Impaler's Catacomb. And that sounds dirty. That certainly sounds dirty. All right, we got the long sword for now. And we're gonna hope it does us justice. So far, oh, my least favorite little guys. Okay, that's a hole to death. I'm sure there's more of them climbing around. I forgot they have projectiles too. Throw one more. I feel like we could use a weapon upgrade now. See, I'm not really... I'm a little worried at what could be in this room. This guy's pulling tricks. Okay. I'm guessing this is gonna be closed. Yep. Locked by a contraption. Typical. Now, do we think there's gonna be a trap in this room? I do. Besides just these stupid little goblins. All right, you can't be the only one. Ah, I was right. All right. Oh, they can inflict bleed. Whoa! Gosh. All right, the Impaler's Catacomb so far, not so good. It's full of the goblins. I did see some stuff today. Still, again, trying not to guide myself through the game with what people online say. There was a few things I did want to know about how to do the summons, when I would have access to more spells or incantations for the faith-based. And I found info on those. And one thing I did learn is that a catacomb, like this place, one of these kind of dungeons, this is where you'll find spirit summons most of the time. You know, it makes sense. A catacomb is a place where you bury people. So, you're finding their spirits still lingering about. And rather than leaving them trapped in a catacomb, we are releasing them so they can fight demons with me. Fitting. Okay. These guys are fast. Ah, and his little friend back there's pissing me off. God. Okay. Let's dance. Alright. Shield up. Not gonna let you ruin my day. They're fast. It's their main advantage. Okay, there's one more. One more. We're gonna have to heal again. As you can see, I'm not on my A game today. I'm glad we didn't start off trying to fight the first knight or whatever that man was from last time. That guy was a little above my pay grade at this moment, but we definitely will return to him. I assure you of that. Maybe just after we get a few more levels, maybe after we upgrade our weapon, because that'll probably give us a pretty good boost to our damage output. And maybe after we find a weapon we actually are a fan of, because so far I'm not loving anything yet. Alright, so just finding more of this grave moss. I didn't read the item. We'll probably pick up more and then we can figure out what the real name was. Alright, this is a big room. Wow, okay, that's an elevator. And it just goes up into spikes. Wow, I'm glad I caught that right away. But I'm trying to think where we could go. Okay, there's an opening over there. So we're gonna run right into that. And we're gonna need our torch at this point. Doesn't look like this is a safe spot. What else is in here? That's just a dead end. Can we run back to the spot we were in? Uh-oh. Can't go down. I guess that corner's the only one we haven't really seen. Well, this can't be all there is to this. That seems a little too simple. We know this is a safe spot. Oh, it doesn't even go all the way up to the spikes. So there has to be something else. Or maybe it just stops moving when we get off it. Uh-oh. Oh! Okay, it does just, it stops at the spikes. Not quite sure where to go. That might be a fake wall, and I think that might be our best bet. Just trying to do that. Not a fake wall. Okay. So what gives? Where do we gotta go? Ah, man. That wall over there with the crack in it. Okay, that doesn't even hurt that bad. Okay, except if you get stuck on it, it's pretty bad. Gosh, okay. That was stupid. Maybe there's a fake wall over there? I mean, we're gonna have to just go back because this puzzle's a little bit much. And now it's just gonna bash me. Unfair. Unfair. It's really not a fake wall. Oh gosh. Well, this is unfortunate. Just a strange. Okay, now we're gonna die. Alright, let's just accept death. It's fine. There was nowhere to progress in that room. And I'm a little confused by it at the moment. Well, we'll find out, I suppose. That was pretty troll. So far, the Impaler's catacombs. Oh, well, I guess it makes sense now, because we were getting impaled. Alright. Now, I think what we need to do over here... let's just run down. Oh, he survived. He landed on something. What? I do not know. But I do know we can't open this door. Still. Ah, gosh. Wrong item. I'm gonna die again. Whew. Lucky block right there. Okay. So, what am I missing? I'm guessing that there is a fake wall somewhere. But see, I've never played one of these games and found a fake wall on my own. I've always let the internet tell me where it was. And now that's not an option. But I really don't want to leave this area. So we're gonna take a look around and try to figure something out. This area, really, nothing happened. There was just that root over there. And it didn't seem like there was anything underneath, necessarily. But now that I'm looking at it, maybe. We're gonna have to find out. Here we go. All right. We can go down here. I guess I should have figured that, but... I don't know. I was worried. I didn't want to fall to my death. We got some ghost glove wart. Is what that is. Alright. And we got some baddies. These guys look a little more casual than our other little friends. But they do kind of look like skeletons. Which means they may have the reanimating feature. I gotta say, you can swing this sword a fair amount of times. Okay. Uh-oh. That's no good. Alright, the non-charged R2 is a nice sweeping attack. Alright, so these guys are gonna keep popping out of the ground. So, we're gonna please help, is what that said. We're not gonna waste time trying to fight all these guys. Also, they can't walk too well. And there's a lot of them down here. Let's keep our eyes up. Alright, we got a ladder over here. It's definitely gonna be the way out. Or the way up to something, at least. I think the main point of this catacomb is gonna be getting that door open from the beginning. But this is a big ladder. Okay. Looks like we might have got that door open. Yep. Somewhere a heavy door has opened. Good news. Good catch by me there. Alright.
Man, that guard counter. It's a great mechanic that they added. You know, I did wish that they would have kept something kind of like the, kind of like the deflection in Sekiro. I thought that was really fun. But it's okay that they didn't. All right, so we're gonna head on into that gate after we rest here real fast. Because of course there's gonna be something behind it, almost a guarantee. All right, so we've rested up. We're gonna pull out the straight sword for now. Uh-oh, that's me falling to my death. Oh, or not. I'm alive. But I'm not supposed to be. Wow, this is an interesting glitch I've gotten myself into. Is there a way I can die? From Software. Why would you do this? What is going on? Alright, I have an item to get out of there, right? Yes, the Memory of Grace. That's interesting. I think that was supposed to kill you, that fall. But I must have fallen at a spot where that wasn't what happened. All right, one more time. I think maybe I just won't try to rush past those goblins because that seemed to turn out pretty poorly. But we just gotta kill these two. One here. Let him fall on down. And his buddy will be over here. Dodging my moves. Okay. But didn't stand much of a chance. Alright, we're gonna see what lies beyond this. Could be a number of things. Alright, here we go. Traverse the mist. We've got, oh, another watchdog. But this one has friends. Okay, so, main problem is the friends, because they're gonna be annoying. So let's try and... Uh-oh. Wow. Wow. Alright, sorry about that, everyone. I didn't know what I was getting myself into. And also, way to give me the same boss that we already fought earlier. This is just like the first episode. Exact same thing. We can probably take it out. It's probably worth it. To get some sort of goodie. Probably some other sort of summon. So this kind of makes me feel like these watchdogs are... Obviously there's more than one of them that are all... have the same job. They watch. That's it. They watch. Gosh. All right. Let's go for it. So, I think the game plan is going to be run in and attack those little guys right away. We just got to watch out for Daddy. Eating my words, as always. Alright. If we could just... There's too many of these things. I don't think I can pull this off. Alright. We got lucky with the... game right there. Oh my gosh. These little boys won't come at me.
All right, we're looking okay now. There we go. Okay. Mono y mono. Only got one flask left. Didn't mean to do that. Okay. We know how to deal with this guy. Okay, he's got some different moves, I'll admit. He has three heads. Is that the main difference than the last one we saw? Alright. Alright, that was a failed guard counter. I hit it right away. I'm still learning the mechanic of it. Oh, wow. Okay. I think we can beat this guy. But I'm not 100% sure. His little friends make it a lot trickier than the last one of these guys we had to deal with. So, with that in mind, we'll head back in. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is some annoying shit, I gotta be honest. This is the annoying shit that pisses people off in these kind of games. This is some Dark Souls 2 kind of shit. Where instead of making a cool boss, they just make a room full of a bunch of difficult enemies that all attack you at once. But we'll go back one more time and give it a go. Oh my god! Stupid. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go back to where I know I can get that spirit summon thing. That way I can summon some of my own little bitches so that they can deal with his stupid little dogs. So, let's go back to where I believe. Cannot fast travel. Oh, okay. Can't fast travel to a site of grace from this location. Then let's go up here. We've covered some ground. Okay. Heading to the church. Oh, critical hit info. Everyone knows that. Just hit the R1 when you're behind them. Okay. May I have a word? This is what I wanted to happen.
A pleasure to meet thee, Tarnished. I am the witch Renna. I'd heard tell of a tarnished hurtling about atop a spectral steed, and upon looking into the matter, the talk, I surmise, is of thee. Thou art possessed of the power, no? To call forth a spectral steed named Torrent. Ah, as I had hoped, I was entrusted this for thee, by Torrent's former master.
There we go. That is what we wanted. Jumping for joy.
'Tis a bell for calling forth spirits. Summon them with it. From ash and return to the earth tree, the spirits will obey thine command but briefly. As they recall battles past, now it is thine to do with as thou wishest.
Okay.
Forgive mine intrusion, Tarnished. I doubt we shall again meet. But all the same, learn well the lands between. How long will it be, I wonder, before the tarnished tire of obeisance to the two fingers?
Okay, she fed us a little bit of story there, but she seems like she might be a bit of a free agent, not tied to anyone. But with all this, I believe now we can summon the Wandering Nobles, which are the ones I'm definitely going to use for that fight we are just at. I did not need to rest at this site of grace. I need to head back to where we were, which was the Impaler's Catacombs. All right, in we go. Now, hopefully, with this spirit summon, we can deal with this in one go? One more go? Need to summon them right away when we get in there.
Hello.
And there's the girlfriend. Putting the pressure on me. Alright, what are my dudes doing? No! Okay, so, come on. One more time, here we go. Maybe I need to use the wolves. Maybe these guys suck. There we go. Okay, these nobles are not worth anything, I gotta be honest. No! No! Okay. I'm really not liking having the... I really don't like having the items and the flasks tied to the same button. It's making it so much harder to cycle... to keep it in mind to cycle through. I'm bitching and moaning right now, I'm gonna be honest. I'm being a bit of a diva. But... come on. Like, I... oh my gosh, okay. I'm aware of it now. I am going to summon the guy and switch back to my flask. And then we will have no issues. Hopefully. We got this. I'm gonna use the wolves instead. And then we'll switch back to the flask. Okay. So far, so good. Okay, so far, pretty good. Is there any more of those little things? Yeah, one more. All right, the dogs are a much better choice than the nobles. Whoa! Alright, all my dogs are gone. But I have a fair amount of health still. I think we can do this. Alright, I know this is boring. We fought this guy before. And if I die again, it's gonna be even worse. All right. Half health. Got him to half health. All right. Oh, broke my block there. Oh, wow, stupid. Wow, I powered up my sword and then put it away. I'm, like I said, still figuring out the controls. All right, here we go. Oh, and we didn't even hit him with it. All right, all right. And we remember, he spins fast. He spins fast. Okay, we know this one. 84, pretty good. One more. Oh, we got greedy. We got greedy. All right, he's got fire again. Nothing new, nothing new. Okay, here we go. This could be the end of it. Just a few more hits on our friend here. No! The range on that is not great. Oh no. Okay, come on. Wow, that was a bad read on my part. All right, one more health. That's it. Okay. We're just gonna wait this out. Okay, and... do it. All right, we're getting close. Oh, he does it twice? Okay, now we're quite literally holding on by a thread. There we go. All right, the second watchdog. We got the demi-human ashes. Good news. All right, we made it through another one. I know it's a little repetitive because we've already dealt with that enemy before. That one was a little different. His fire spray had a little more spread to it. I think it, because it had more heads on it. But we dealt with it. And that is the end of getting through of the Impaler's Catacomb. Which, let's be real, is very similar to the catacomb we found at the beginning of the game. I don't have too many complaints about this game so far. One of my complaints would be that that was extremely similar to the spot before it. But with that being said, I'm going to end this episode right about here. Hopefully you enjoyed this content, even though it was a little similar to some of our old stuff, but we're still getting the hang of it. So, this is the end of episode 4 of the Elden Ring Let's Play, and I will see you all next time in the Lands Between.